Just mentioned that plume is nearing Huntington, West Virginia, and this topic, of course, is very concerning and kind of hard to understand at times. So today I spent the day talking to a UC professor who explains what this will mean once it gets downstream here to Cincinnati.
It's a big concern up here, but the level of concern has been decreasing as it goes down the river.
UC Assistant Professor Dr. Patrick Gray is tracking the aftermath of that fiery train derailment in East Palestine and chemicals spilling into the water, including the Ohio River.
Here is where the butyl acrylate is right now. It's a couple days upstream of Huntington and about a week upstream of Cincinnati.
Concern spiking after 3,500 fish died.
There's a little stream here. And the stuff is coming from a little stream down into the Ohio River. And in this little stream, it might have been quite intense in its concentration. It could have really hurt animals and plants and things in this area. But by the time it entered into the Ohio River, which is huge, it's diluted a lot.
Government and environmental teams are tracking the plume's path, testing river samples and monitoring any potential health concerns.
It is going down. Yeah, they were detecting 12 before, and so it's been going down as it's gotten to here, where it's about 4. And maybe by the time it gets to Huntington, we don't know for sure, but if it continues to decrease as it's going, by the time it gets to Huntington, it might be almost undetectable.
If the chemicals continue the journey at 1 mile per hour, the river has its own built-in safety valves.
There's 19 locks and dams all along the Ohio River.
He says if the chemicals created a health concern, there's other man-made steps crews can take.
We have two reservoirs right next to the river, and we can pull from those for at least 2 days.
And now he also added that crews could shut off water intakes and they can actually even filter out this chemical. So once again, there's no active threat to Cincinnati right now. But once again, crews are continuing to monitor this situation. Reporting live along the Ohio River, Danielle Dendek, WLWT News 5.
All right, Dan.